Hey guys, Mikadaman here, another video with you guys. Today we're going to do an unboxing video for stuff that I ordered online. Specifically, it's from Right Stuff Anime. For you guys who don't know what Right Stuff Anime is, it's actually a website based in Iowa where they kind of like just, you know, sell stuff anime related or manga related or whatever merchandise you could, like, you know, purchase from them. So I ordered actually this last March the 2nd, and actually just arrived today. I was actually excited for reading this, but yeah. So without further ado, let's just get started. So I don't have any tools for opening, but I actually get this hex screw or handy dandy. I may catch pretty well, so whatever. yeah. You know what, actually, this hex screw cuts pretty well in the tapes they're using. Here, let me show it to you. I know, it's really stupid, but oh well, I don't have any scissors or whatever, but there you go. Alright. Actually, I'm pretty impressed with how, like, you know, Right Stuff packages these stuff. You'll just know that these are pretty sturdy and, like, they're really well protected. These are actually... Yeah, no worries. There you go. Actually, how they pack. These are packed with a lot of cardboards and stuff. Alright, so for the element of, like, you know, I'm actually spoiling you guys. Let me open this up. So I actually ordered these stuff. These are actually the JoJo Part 3, the Stardust Crusader, as well as Tomy and the No Longer Human by Junji Ito. So yeah, first let's get the Tomy. I'm pretty excited about this. So as you can see, I'm actually really impressed with the Right Stuff's packaging, because, you know, as you can see right here, they actually packed in order for the books not to be moved all along or, like, all around. So let's see here, they're stuffing a lot of papers. It's pretty impressive, protecting your mangas, your books. Let me get this out of the way. Yep. So first, let me get this. No Longer Human. This manga is actually based from Osamu Dazai's novel. So right here, this is the cover. It's pretty actually impressive because it's sleeved, actually, as you can see right here. Look at just how good or gorgeous the artwork is with Junji Ito. It's really impressive. If you guys are really interested with horror manga, you should really, really pick up Junji Ito's, you know, mangas. They're pretty good. I would suggest maybe picking up first is Uzumaki, because that is, like, you know, they're very straightforward. Like, every chapter in Uzumaki is, like, kind of like a standalone, like, you know, it has its own stories, but it's still based on the same setting. But yeah, this is No Longer Human. It's about human psych, you know, problems with dealing human psychology or human psych. So right here, you can see original novel by Osamu Dazai. As you may know, this is a novelist. It's actually based from what he calls them. His novel, this manga, Junji Ito actually adapted this, so this is not his original story, but still pretty good, thick, but I'm not gonna spoil you guys, so let's move on. No longer human. Next is another Junji Ito's work, Tommy. As you may know, this is like the trio book, because if you notice the design of the books that Junji Ito has with Tomi, Uzumaki, and Gyo has the same design, which is like this. I actually like the design because how black, red, and gray, you know, complements each other through the color and actually the spine. There you go. It's really, really good. Just look at it. I mean, if you line up on your shelf using this with the other books like the Uzumaki, the Gyo, and the Tomi, it will actually look really good, like especially the spine lining up. Yeah, so this actually, Tomi Kawakami is a female fatale with long black hair and a beauty mark just under her left eye. She can seduce nearly any man and drive them to murder as well. Even though the victim is often Tomi herself, while one lover seeks to keep her for himself, another grows terrified of immortal succubus. But soon they realize that no matter how many times they kill her, the world will never free of Tomi. Well, yes, so if you want to pick this one up as well, I would really recommend this one. Because for me, out of the three, the trio that Junji Ito makes, the Uzumaki, the Gyo, and the Tomi, I think the Tomi is one of the best, in my opinion. Yep, so moving on, we have here our JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Because I actually ordered 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, because I actually picked up the volume 3 and 10 from, you know, Kinokuniya. If you guys don't know what Kinokuniya is, it's like a manga shop chain located wherever, like, we have here in Chicago, and I think it's a pretty decent store for manga, so yeah, let's move on. So this is the volume 4, as you can see the artwork right there. Usually these hardbounds, the artwork is like, you know, the characters, Inuyasha, whatever. Nice free artwork. This is volume 8, the dog. Dog's name is Iki. Funny name, right? But, and then at the back, the fool. I don't know, if you guys haven't tried JoJo, I would really suggest trying it. I know it's really weird, the artwork, but trust me, it's really good. The story, the artwork will really grow into you. You'll really love it as soon as, like, you know, try to read it along further. Yeah. There we go. Volume 7, the RB Elder. At the back, Osiris. Next, Volume 5, Noriaki Kakyoin. Here's the artwork. And then Hierophant Green. I think he is a stand, because, you know, stands were introduced until like part 3 of Stardust Crusaders. So if you want to start JoJo, I would suggest to start part 1. It's really good. It's about how the JoJo adventures start with Joseph. Or, sorry, Jonathan, I mean, rather. Here we go. The other one, Jean-Pierre Polnareff. Silver Chariot on the back of Volume 9. Next is Volume 2. Here we go, Joseph Joestar. He is actually the protagonist in the part 2, or what they call the battle tendency. Oh man, I think the battle tendency of the part 2 is really good as well. Here we go, the art at the back. Yep. Alright, here is the volume 1, the pretty good the protagonist. As you may all know, it's like the iconic of JoJo as well, I believe. Jotaro Kujo, the protagonist of part 3, Stardust Crusader. As well as his stand, Star Platinum, right here on the art, as you can see right there. Man, these are like, you know, good quality hardbound mangas. Last but not least, Volume 6. Muhammad Abdul, Magician Shred. Yeah, so these are the stuff that I actually ordered with Red Stuff Anime. If you want, I could leave the link down below. Oh, so because of the promo, I get to have this face mask, whatever they call this, Design 100 or whatever. Yeah, and then a sticker from East Coast Manga, I guess. Yep. And then they include the receipt right here. So yeah, basically that's unboxing with Right Stuff Anime. I think they're pretty good. You should really try. Aside from the fact that they have really good packaging, their price is below retail, so you could really save a lot. Especially if like they'll do a lot of promos, winter sale or birthday sale of Right Stuff Anime, you could really save a lot of money if you're into physical manga. So yeah, I think that's for today. Thanks guys, and have a good one.